Welcome. Today is All Hallows' Eve.
I'm sad.
Yeah, because Halloween is just about ending by the time this video comes out.
I'm sad because of my existence.
Today, we'll get to that, I guess.
That's horror, Eric. That's true horror.
That is true horror, yes.
Ask Mary Shelley.
Come to terms with that, yeah.
She's dead.
Did you come to terms with that? You can't ask her.
Today, we're going to be getting really spooky with Guillermo del Toro, the master of spookies, modern spookies, I guess. He came out with a new show or an anthology of all these friends of his. He's got a lot of director friends, and they all made a little short movie for this Cabinet of Curiosities. So we're going to dive into the first two, and maybe we'll... I don't know if you guys are interested in watching these on your own. We can come back at a certain time and discuss it as a whole, and then come out with like our favorite stories. But this should be really interesting. I was looking forward to this because of the spooky time.
Yeah, a lot of cool directors. Yeah, I think this is like a more high end like Alfred Hitchcock Presents or Twilight Zone.
Twilight Zone
or Tales from the Crypt or Together like that.
Yep. And, the first episode looks like it's called Lot 36.
Yep. I'm guessing it has something to do with, auction.
Ooh.
It's an auction.
Nice. Well,
no, nope, it's a storage unit.
Storage
Fuck.
Unit. Yeah.
Just read the description.
Yeah, from what I've seen, Tim Blake Nelson, I think, is in this episode, too.
Oh, TBN, dude?
Yeah.
My boy.
Buster Scruggs.
Who's the director of this one?
I don't know. Maybe we'll see at the beginning, but...
Because they're all, like, recent horror directors and stuff.
Right.
Like, people that you may not know the name, but you'll know movies they did.
Right, so I think we'll just dive into it, and we'll just go along for the ride. How about that? We'll come back after we watched it and just discuss a little bit. So go out there and watch it. It's on Netflix.
Deal it, Will. The fear.
You're telling me rats is stealing bodies out of coffins.
Big rats.
We need to get back there.
Rats stealing bodies out of
coffins. I'm very worried about you.
Very worried about you.
Don't think you should use that.
Don't you dare close it.
Oh gosh.
Martin Starr? Yeah.
Tonight I'm going to gift you a singular experience. What am I going to find?
Is that fucking RoboCop?
It sounded like it.
Is that Eric Andre? What the hell?
What was that?
The darkness.
Are you serious? Was that fucking...
It's Prince Caspian.
No, not Prince Caspian. What's... Not...
Maybe I ran.
Not Amadeus, the other guy. I think he was also in The Godfather.
Are you thinking of F. Murray Abraham?
F. Murray Abraham.
Fuck Murray Abraham, dude!
I think that was F. Murray Abraham who, like, stabbed something into his eye.
Our boy Maybe. Fuck Murray is in this, dude?
You got fucking Tim Blake Nelson. You got possibly F. Murray Abraham.
Fuck Murray, dude.
We're getting the triple name triad. We're getting the
fucking... TBN, TBN. Fucking...
FMA.
FMA. Then we need another one.
Well,
JTT.
Within the first 5 minutes, we brought up JTT and
he's not actually in this, though.
No, he's not in this.
It doesn't matter. It's tangentially. We said it during this show. It matters.
Would you say that Guillermo belongs to that, even though Del Toro is technically his last name? But Guillermo of the Bull, dude?
Well, he chose his name to be Guillermo del Toro, like, officially that is his business name. He could have been Guillermo del Toro. He could have been William Toro. He could have been any number of things.
Toro. I want to see a William Toro movie, dude.
Billy, old Bill Toro.
All right, so we just finished watching Lot 36. What'd you guys think of that?
That was tight.
Yeah. I like that.
I loved it.
It was more overt than I thought it was going to be, and I'm glad that it was.
I liked how it was a subtle one. I'm glad that was the first one we watched, or that's the first one of the series.
Did you say that was subtle?
Well, I liked how it was a slow burn, I guess.
Yeah.
And then,
yeah.
I like that's what I was going to say. Like when we were like 2/3 of the way full through it, I was like, sitting there thinking, I was like, oh, it's building the tension and building everything, so all the horror is at like the end.
Well, it's set up everything so well. How he hates or he's prejudiced and then has his comeuppance and all that kind of pays off.
Yep.
All of it fit perfectly into place.
I would be curious to read like Guillermo's short story to see if there's any more to that. See like his background maybe of his experience in the war, why he's a racist, but like just getting more story would be fun.
Yeah, I'm interested to see the rest of the series. So we're gonna get into the Graveyard Rats. This is the part of the trailer we just saw.
This is the one.
Oh, nice. The monster was cool in Lot 36 too, by the way.
So good. And
yeah.
All the stuff leading up to like, oh my god, it had like a Necronomicon or like the Book of some kind of dead and summoning demons and how to use a sacrificial body that they use from like the newspaper clippings of Dottie. Like that was that was great. It was good. Good reveal. And then the serpentine kind of Cthulhu monster that is bored itself inside the skull.
If this is gonna be like the thing about this show where it's like, hey, there's other horror shows where maybe it's like you don't know how much horror in it, you know? Overt horror.
Yeah.
If this continues and it goes down and they present themselves as something of like, hey, come on in for horror, and you know that you're gonna get stuff like monsters and like cool fun overt shit like this, I'm in. Do 20 seasons of this.
And that was another Guillermo, wasn't it? The director of that last one was a Guillermo.
Yeah, Guillermo Navarro.
Navarro.
I was gonna say too, I loved the Guillermo intro too.
Mm-hmm. Very Jonathan Frakes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ripley's Believe It or Not.
Fucking Alfred Hitchcock. This fucking really Rod Sterling.
Oh my god.
Sven Gulli.
Todd McFarlane for the Spawn series.
I'm Todd McFarlane. Dude, I found a video that was a compilation of Leading an Army from Hell.
Well, that's
that was a compilation of the first season, like intros, Todd McFarlane intros. God damn, they're hilarious.
I'm like, I want these presenter characters to have conversations with each other.
I'm Todd McFarlane.
I'm
the creator of Spawn.
That's what Al Simmons thought when he died. Well, he certainly came back, and then Jonathan Frakes is like,
nope. He talks a lot about lovemaking in those two in that first season.
I love sex.
Todd McFarlane.
I love sex. Yeah. I love making
beautiful
love.
Wife that he likes to make love to.
Yeah, I'm making love to your wife. God damn it. He does say that.
We're gonna jump into the next episode here, and we'll be back in the next episode. Hope you guys are enjoying this Cabinet of Curiosities.